Then we come to Thebes, the city of the 100 gates. The Arabs called it Luxor, which means the palaces when they found in it huge temples that they have never seen before. Luxor is the world's largest outdoors museum. It contains one-third of the ancient world's monuments. Ramses II left his fingerprints everywhere in Luxor. In front of the Luxor Temple, he erected two obelisks, of which only one still remains. On the temple's pylon, he recorded his military victories. The Karnak Temple is the largest religious complex in the world. In its glorious days, it contained 20 temples, chapels, and ceremonial halls. Ramses II completed the hypostyle hall in the Karnak Temple, a petrified forest of 143 columns. Some of them are 20 meters high. And above Karnak, above Luxor, the obelisks stand high to witness the glory of ancient Egypt. Across the Nile, on the western bank of Thebes, the sun sets every evening behind the Valley of the Kings. Over there, we find in the tombs of the kings, queens, and nobles, colorful wall paintings showing the other world, the world of eternal life. Ancient Egyptians built many temples along the Nile Valley. The best way to visit these temples is to take a Nile cruise between Luxor and Aswan. There are over 200 cruisers to choose from. Cruisers are elegant and spacious. On the sun deck, you will enjoy the warm sun of Upper Egypt and watch the life on the banks of the Nile. You will visit the temple of Hathor in Dendera, goddess of love and joy. The temple of the falcon god Horus at Idfu is still very well preserved. The temple of Komombo overlooks the Nile. It was built for the two gods, Sobek and Horaris. Finally, we come to Aswan, the queen of winter resorts, where the Nile flows between green islands and granite cataracts. South of Aswan, on an island in the Nile, we find the temple of Philae, built for goddess Isis. The worship of Isis reached Europe. The temple was still open for worship until the year 565 AD. Kilometers south of Aswan in the land of Nubia, there are the temples of Abu Simbel. The whole world contributed to save these temples from the rising waters of the Nile after building the high dam. The temples were cut and then relocated. Abu Simbel ends our trip in the valley of the Nile. Let us go now to see another face of Egypt. Egypt, the sun and the sea.